I believed everything had feelings, that there was no such thing as an inanimate object. And I was telling all the other kids this. There were complaints from parents, and the teachers didn't like it, that a pencil had feelings. Don't bite the pencil. You want me to bite you? Pencil doesn't want you to bite it. It was obsessive compulsive patterns, and they expelled me from third grade at PS 64. You know, I was looking at stuff when I was very young. I was aware of space, I was aware of that handball court as a plane and a volume of the building behind. There's awareness, then there's an understanding or an acknowledgement of that which you're aware of. Then there's incorporating those feelings or that information somehow. That's the column you just printed.
Mm-hmm.
I think Norland's gonna have to print them each at the 36. We're gonna look.
Okay.
That's gonna give them different heights.
Mm-hmm.
And just begin to play them next to one another.
Mm-hmm.
And this only started a year ago, and it started as a total accident. I was doing something completely different. I wanted to scan every side of a seven-sided block just to understand them. And I cantilevered, so the block would keep falling over, so I threw some stuff under it. I was gonna crop out everything else. And it was shocking. This first scan, it was all of a sudden an opportunity. So then I did a couple more, then it found itself. But it's always about relationships
between elements, between things that are going on.
You know, I refer to that as critical distance. You take the pitcher's mound to home plate. If that were any closer, nobody would be able to hit. If you moved it further away, everybody could hit. It's the right distance for what it is that it's doing. These things occur all the time everywhere, particularly within vernacular circumstances. You just have to look to see it. You have to pay attention, and then you have to acknowledge it. So I may find something laying on the street, and it may just start a whole thing, a whole process. there's that wonderful term, elegance. The simplest way to arrive at the greatest result is as good as you can do. That's in 1980, in an abandoned Palestinian refugee house. Those proportions are elegant, plain and simple. Look at that door. That is so sophisticated, design-wise. The three panels are all different. They're three different heights. They're all the same width. I believe that aesthetically, three equal panels it wouldn't have been as good. That's a pretty elegant solution in what you would think is not an elegant situation worthy of that kind of decision-making process.
What do you think about detail shots, just overall resolution?
I think it's very good. The only thing that stands out to me is this color in that square.
I think, Chris, is that the one that you've done the most pulls, or this one?
Yeah, they're mostly around three to four pulls.
So where are you finding these materials, these objects?
All over my studio. For me, it's about defining my concerns. It's how we decide on a crop, how we decide on what is connecting to what. Based on the circumstances and conditions, it's very particular. And I believe conveyable, even if not acknowledged intellectually. Now, I apply those same things to individual sculptures or to the gouaches or to these images, but I don't do it with the sense of providing anything to anybody. I guess what's maybe unique to me is that I've worked on proposals, concepts, built projects that have varied from 400 acres to something that I've done that's that size. Sometimes I think they may all have a sense of a grand scale. You look at this, no more monumental than that, right? You all of a sudden take this piece of glass. You look at it like that. Total change in scale. It's what it's in relationship to. Well, I mean, some of it is definitely chemical. I mean, that there's no question about. When I was doing a lot of the earlier projects and working with a lot of different people, my behavior would be terrible in those situations. I was in a state of constant, no impulse control, zero, a very short fuse, and terribly angry at any form of authority. So people either loved me or they hated me. I was caught up in the notion that things had to be dark in order for you to see light, that melancholia, depression, all of it made better work friends would say to me, do you actually think to do what you do, you have to be miserable? And I guess I thought it came from that dark place, you know? I'm not angry anymore, so I'm liberated by that. That's taken years of real focus and work, same kind of focus I bring to a project, bringing not being self-destructive. Yeah, came late.